Hello, this is my response to one of Brian's logics videos called Complementary Angles. It's centered around this image here, and what this image says is for a flat earth, if you double the complementary angle, the distance to the GP more than doubles. That's obviously in conflict with the 60 nautical miles per degree that everybody agrees with. So let's go ahead and find out why this is a problem for flat Earth and it's not a problem for globe Earth. In this representation, we have the globe Earth, we have Polaris, we have its GP at the North Pole, and we've got a couple of observers, one and two. Observer one is 1500 nautical miles from the GP. Observer two is 1500 nautical miles from observer one. So the question is now, can we get observer 1's angle to equal 65, observer 2's angle to equal 40, while at the same time maintaining the 1500 nautical miles for all three points? So in order to do that, I'm going to delete these here, and we're going to draw some zenith lines for each observer. We are going to give each a horizon. And in order to measure the angles to Polaris, we need some points on each horizon. So to measure the angle for observer one, we do that. And to measure the angle for observer two, we do that, and what you see is 40.5 degrees for observer 1 and 7.2 degrees for observer 2. Obviously, that's nothing like this, and that's because Polaris is too darn close. So in reality, it's over 300 light years away, and the light that will come from this star will be in parallel when it hits Earth. This is not in parallel, this is too close, and this is why we're getting strange angles here. So let's zoom out and we'll move Polaris further away. Not 300 light years further away, but enough. So that, for all intents and purposes, the light coming from this star will be in parallel when it hits Earth. So let's zoom back into Earth and see what angles we're getting now. Okay. So now we are getting the 65 and the 40 that we expect from globe Earth. The complementary angle for observer 1 is 25 degrees. And when you multiply that by 60, you get 1500. And the complementary angle for observer 2 is 50 degrees, multiply that by 60, you have 3000. This is correct. This satisfies the 60 nautical miles per degree. We have no problem with globe Earth when multiple observers are viewing one star. In this representation, we've got a flat Earth and our star Polaris is some way above the flat Earth. Its GP is at the North Pole, and we have a couple of observers again, number one and two. When we look side on to the flat Earth, we can see these two observers, and they're both looking at Polaris. Observer one looks up at the sky, and he measures an angle of 65 degrees to Polaris. And we've got observer number two, and he looks up at the sky, and he sees it at 40 degrees to Polaris. Now bear in mind, we are looking at both of these observers at exactly the same time, and they are both looking up at the sky, looking at the star. The complementary angle for observer 1 is 25, and when you multiply that by 60, you get 1500, so this is fine. And the complementary angle for observer 2 should be 50, and when you multiply that by 60, that should be 3000. That should be this distance here, to the GP. But when you add these two numbers up, you get a lot more than 3,000. This is clearly longer than 1,500. So what's going on? Now, Brian would say, hold up a minute. Observer 2 is clearly wrong, and it should be 1,500 miles also. But when you do that, look what happens. So the complementary angle for observer 2 is now 43 degrees, which makes the distance from observer 2 to the GP 2,580 nautical miles. But here we clearly see it's 1,500 plus 1,500, which is 3,000 nautical miles. What is causing that mismatch? So the problem for flat Earth is you have a flat baseline, you have straight lines of sight to a star from multiple locations. These lines form triangles, and triangles have mathematics behind them. There is no place at all where you can manipulate these distances or this height. None at all where you can get this angle equal 40, this 65, this distance 1500, and this distance 1500. There isn't any. The globe representation had no issues at all respecting the 60 miles per degree, but the flat Earth representation is problematic throughout. So Brian, you're the flat Earth expert. You show us how it should be done.